Are you in the market for a new protein powder and wanting to just make the cleanest choice for yourself, your family? Today we're going to be getting into it. Hi, I'm Taylor Wessel, nutritionist of Tailored Health, and every week I pop on here to share a tip, tool, or technique that will help you be your healthiest self. And today we are talking protein powders. There are so many on the market, from whey to soy to rice to pea and collagen and everything in between. So what is the best and cleanest choice? Protein powders are a supplement to the diet. Always best to go to food first and get your protein from sources such as wild-caught fish, pasture-raised eggs, legumes, so beans, peas, lentils, maybe a homemade bone broth. However, when in a pinch or when making a superfood smoothie, how do you add that extra element of protein so you stay full for longer, but you're not putting a bunch of junk into your system? One of my top go-tos is collagen. Collagen is the most abundant protein within your body. It is essentially the building blocks of your bones, your joints, your tendons, your skin. It holds them all together. This is great for hair, skin, nails, anti-aging, fighting fine lines and wrinkles. We need more collagen in our diets, and the thing is, we're just not getting it from the foods that we're eating. Collagen comes from the bones of animals. So this is not going to be vegetarian. This is coming from grass-fed cows. So important when you are buying collagen to look for the highest quality, because those bones can be loaded with heavy metals or toxins from the foods that they're eating, water supply, and things that they're being injected with. I like Vital Proteins, I'll link below. You can put a scoop or two scoops into your shake in the morning. I even add this to soups because it just ups the protein element, keeps me full for longer, and just for preventative measures as far as anti-aging goes. On the same lines, from the same company, is beef gelatin. Vital Proteins also makes this, which is a little bit less processed than the collagen. It's not as user-friendly. Collagen blends right into water. And just a note too on collagen is there is collagen that comes from fish as well, wild-caught fish, if you are vegetarian and have fish in your diet but want to incorporate collagen. Anyways, back to gelatin. So this is less processed than the collagen peptides, not as easy to digest, and not as user-friendly because when you add this to cold fluids, it does tend to bulk up kind of like Jell-O. I like that because I like to make my smoothies more spoonable rather than sippable. It's more fulfilling to actually chew on something. It slows you down, number one, and sends a message to the brain that you're actually eating something and makes you less likely to be hungry sooner. I will add a scoop of this to my superfood smoothie in the morning or to my soups. Use it similar to the collagen, but again, this is coming from grass-fed cows, so not a vegetarian source. Along those same lines, Designs for Health makes a pure paleo protein powder, and this is bone broth based. Now, this is going to be less processed than the collagen or the gelatin because it contains everything coming from bone broth, from the collagen and gelatin to the different minerals and amino acid structures. This is about as pure as it gets and higher in protein than both of the other sources that I talked about. You can add a scoop of this, again, to your superfood smoothies. It's a little bit chalky. They do have different flavors, vanilla, chocolate. I like to go plain as much as possible to avoid any kind of natural flavoring or even artificial sweeteners that might not react well to your system. The last one, my fourth option, is hemp seeds. Hemp protein powder is packed with fiber. Hemp is actually a complete plant-based protein. Animal protein has all of the essential amino acids that we can't make within our diet, the 9 essential amino acids. A lot of those plant proteins are missing one or two, so they cannot make the complete structures that build your bones, joints, tendons, your skin, etc. So you do have to have little bits of all sorts of plant protein to fill in the amino acid structure. Hemp seeds have all of those, so you don't even have to worry about it. There is 13 grams of fiber for 4 tablespoons. That is almost half of the recommended daily intake of fiber a day in just your morning smoothie if you're adding this in. This is your vegetarian or vegan source, about as pure and clean as you can get. You can also get hemp seeds in their shell that aren't blended down to a powder form. And those actually blend in a little bit nicer. I will say that this is a little bit gritty. I actually like to add a scoop of the gelatin to kind of bulk up my smoothie and then add this as a topper, just for kind of almost like a cracker crumble on top of some of my smoothies. I like that texture. Experiment with this one and see if you like it. Those are my top recommended protein powders, going with a grass-fed collagen or gelatin, a grass-fed bone broth, or hemp seeds if you're trying to go more plant-based. You want to try to avoid conventional soy or even having too much soy in your diet in general. Whey, although it's the fastest absorbing and acting protein, a lot of people react to dairy and especially the protein component. I would just encourage you to try one of these first. And if you are going to still go for whey, always making sure that it is organic and coming from grass-fed cows. As far as the other plant-based proteins, some are great. I do like Garden of Life and Sun Warrior. I'll link to some of these protein powders below. But a lot of them have junky ingredients like natural flavoring or artificial sweeteners or even chemicals, binders, and fillers to keep it shelf stable for longer. None of the protein powders that I talked about have any unnecessary added elements to them. They're well tolerated even for sensitive individuals. So I feel confident recommending these. Again, you have to experiment for yourself. Find one or two that work for you and kind of rotate. We are meant to rotate our foods, even down to supplements. I hope this helped you to now have some purchasing power and some knowledge going into Whole Foods or Vitamin Shop or ordering online your next protein powder. And just to do that little bit better when it comes to your superfood smoothie that you're putting in so much effort for. Again, you can add these to soups as well. If you like this, give it a like, share it with somebody who is about that protein powder life and just isn't as educated, or you know that they're using a junky protein powder, and subscribe to my channel. Every week I am coming at you with something like this that will help educate you, motivate you, and give you a tip or two.